when people first meet me, I'm just like, they don't know whether to kind of warm to me or hate me. But that's all right, man, I'll be Marmite. Do you know what I mean? I'll be fucking Marmite. It's good. I was always kind of interested in doing something different and kind of just, I don't know, for me it was just like, in my way it's right. I just think it's like, a lot of young people feel like their voice isn't important because of people suppressing their ideas. You know, and to me, man, that just fucks up because everyone's voice is important and then that's what young blood is about. Thanks, we can all cut this shit together, do you know what I mean? I don't want to be fuck you because it's been done so many fucking times before. Because as soon as a fucking punch is thrown, the argument's lost. Because no one listens to the words you're saying, they just see that you've thrown a punch. I just think this fuck, we got our priorities wrong. Like, oh, like in the UK right now, man, we can compete with other countries and the world can determine who's got the biggest weapons and who's got the biggest warship, but a 19-year-old young person can't go to university for free. And what was weird when I first went to America, man, this was like fucking bonkers, man. Gun law is like a big fucking issue for me. You know what I mean? I think like when I first went to America, I just find it crazy that for me right now, on paper, it's easier for me to get hold of an assault rifle than it is a pint of beer in America. America. I just find that crazy. I'm like, what? And for me, man, it was Brexit. That was my first opportunity that I could vote or I could have a say that was gonna determine my future. You know what I mean? It was gonna make a difference to the world that I was gonna live in.
Because they're just so frightened of the repercussions.
There's a place in your stomach that can trick you. There's a place in your head that can just make you go round and round and drive you fucking mad and nobody just actually knows the why. Today, you made me feel irrelevant. Twisted my intelligence. Made it seem there's no brain in my head. I'm like a skeleton. Can't shut my eyes. You know what I mean? It's kind of so good right now because finally mental health has been taken seriously. Sometimes a lot of controversy because people say it's uncomfortable and it can trigger them. And yeah, man, of course it can, but for me, man, like, art should be speaking about stuff like that because, yeah, it's uncomfortable having anxiety, but you know what's more uncomfortable? People not understanding what you're going through. And when it's talked about in art and when it's kind of spoken about, and when it's like, when it's expressed in art, it makes people who would not have a clue normally understand it and learn and be able to notice what someone's going through, you know what I mean? And for me that's so important because that's what music's supposed to do. It's supposed to make you feel things. There's a part in your head that can make you go insane. You know what I mean? Some days like you wake up and you're just like, everything, it just takes your breath away and you just kind of just become tight and you can't kind of function properly. Drugs and shit are weird, man, because I've always had a lot of energy, so I've never needed them. But I think my kind of take on drugs is like, it's this chemical version of happiness that you're never going to replicate in real life. So your life just becomes a little bit darker. It takes you to a level that you can't reach in real life. And for me, that just doesn't make sense because fuck drugs, man. You know what I mean? It's giving me fucking energy. Hugs, not drugs. You know what I mean?
Doctor, doctor, give me a lobotomy so I don't see what is in front of me. Crash, bang goes the crate. Dull. Doctor, doctor, give me a remedy to a red button doomsday melody.
Embrace your fucking, embrace your issues.
doctor consent happily. Take out my brain and my sanity. Your name's on the label.
Well, from my eyes. Oh, fuck. It's all out of focus, man. I was at a fucking March for Our Lives in Atlanta, right? And people underestimate young people. You know what I mean? People underestimated young people in the fact that they could not create a fucking march that would unite people across the world. But you know what? They saw the power of young people that day. And that just fucking made me so fucking excited. I was in Atlanta and there was 250,000 people in one state turned up. I'm so sick of dividing. It's an old school way of thinking. Why do we want to be divided? My version of punk, I don't want to divide people in my version of punk. I want to unite people for one greater cause. We see a future that we want to be a part of. It's fucking right there, but it's been held back by old perception, and it's been held back by a generation that don't necessarily understand us or just aren't quite ready for the world to go to that place. You are told as a young person, like, to be fucking, to calm down because you're gonna get there, but it's like, won't I be an adult when I get there? So I'm not gonna be a young person. So you're just basically saying, wait till you're a fucking adult, then why can I not seize this opportunity now? I'm smart enough, I'm intelligent enough, we're powerful enough together, I can grab this opportunity now. You're telling me to wait until I'm 35 years old, but then I'm just gonna be like you. You know what I mean? I just want to be straight up. I just say, take the fucking muzzle off me. You know what I mean? Because people are afraid of what they don't understand. So you got to fucking make them understand and be persistent and just fucking keep drilling your point. Because if it's fucking spoken about enough, that's when we change shit. How are people going to know who you are if you just remain quiet? How are they going to say, when you fucking die, that's what that person represented? It's going to be fucking hard, but it's so easy to fucking feel nothing. That's why people stay in the same place for so fucking long. Just having that lack of fear to just go, fuck it. And just to jump and just say what you think. And that's fucking it, man. It's just a fundamental fear to fucking jump. It's so funny, like, especially with the internet now, You're putting yourself out to the world, and you can be judged in a second by everybody.
I think do what you think is right. That's the most important thing. At the end of the day, if someone doesn't like you for who you are, or someone doesn't want to acknowledge what you've got to say, then they're just not meant to be in your life.
I'm not a monster. Do you know what I mean? I am self-conscious. Of course I'm self-conscious. But that's the fun bit. You got to ride the fucking fear.